is the Simpit. I'm your host, Sean Cole. But the real star of today's show is the cure. The cure for the need for speed. What am I talking about? You know, the cure. The cure for the need for speed. If you're anything like me, I've been through my share of 2, 3, 4 day driving schools. I've raced a variety of different cars. And at this point, it can actually be difficult to think of or find something unique that's going to cure that need for the speed. Now, on a recent vacation with an old racing buddy of mine who has a lot of driving experience as well, we were trying to think of something fun, some thrill ride, something exhilarating to do. And then I stumbled upon Exotics Racing. Exotics Racing has a fleet of supercars to choose from. I mean, we're talking Ferraris, Lamborghinis, Porsches, McLarens, Mercedes, Audis, and more. You will find an Exotic Racing in both Los Angeles, somewhat close to me, and also their main headquarters in Las Vegas. So I went to their website to see what kind of fun we could have, and I gotta tell you, the fun actually begins right there. The minute I got to their website, I got a big smile on my face as I'm looking through Ferraris, Lamborghinis, and Porsches, just imagining the type of car that I could drive, and it was like the lottery game, just imagining these cars that I'd never be able to drive in my lifetime. Now they're here on the web page for me to select. And I was lured in by that drive a Ferrari for $299. But once I got there, I started looking at options, and you know it, I wanted more. More cars, more track time, more smiles. So I uncorked my wallet and I jumped in for what they call the triple threat package. 3 supercars, yes, 3 supercars. Now that has got to be the cure for the need for speed. The triple threat package would allow me to drive 3 of my all-time favorite cars, the Ferrari F430, the Lamborghini Gallardo, and the Porsche 911 GT3, and 5 laps at speed in each of them. So we pulled up to California Speedway and pulled through the main gate. Exotics Racing has their own section of the facility, and after you park, you can walk right up to the cars. It's like pulling up to a car show with all of the beautiful works of art sitting at the ready next to the track. They are gleaming, they are sparkling, and unlike any car show that I've ever been to, they're actually gonna hand me the keys and let me drive them. Now, after registering with Exotics Racing, it's on to the classroom section of our day. An instructor will give you the basics of car control, the basics of the racing line, and an idea of what you will be doing on the track. He also shows you the track layout and explains the important spots on the track. The track itself is a 1.2 mile, 8-turn course with a nice variety of corner types. The track is actually a repaved section of the California Speedway parking lot that is fairly flat, but built to let you really get a feel for what these cars can do. After the classroom instruction, we are ushered trackside, and then we are put into a Porsche Cayenne where the instructor would take us on some recon laps. The first lap is actually at medium speed, as he points out braking cones, turn-in cones, and other important points on the track. By the second lap, the pace is increased massively, and it becomes quite a wild ride with the G-forces throwing you around, and the instructor points things out at a much faster pace.
Turn in gently back to throttle, find your next apex, and squeeze hard full throttle once you're pointed. Gotta brake real hard here, looking through the turn, brake right past the first apex, find your next one, off the brakes, turn down sharp. But that is our 2 discovery laps. Head back into the pits.
So after the recon laps, it's time for your drive. Now, depending on what you've picked, you'll go up to the board and you'll tell them you're ready to drive. In my case, again, it was 3 supercars, starting with the Ferrari F430 F1, a 490 horsepower mid-engine car that can get you up to 60 miles per hour in 3.9 seconds and has a top speed of 198 miles an hour. It starts out with meeting your driving coach. This is the guy who's gonna sit in the passenger seat and give you instruction while you're driving. He takes you to the car, he gets you into the seat, he gets you comfortable and in a good driving position, seat belted, ready to go. Then he jumps into the passenger seat and he gives you some basic instruction on what you're about to do, like where are the paddle shifters that you're gonna be using and the kind of commands he's gonna give you so you'll know how to follow best. And then just a few minutes later, we pull out on track. The Ferrari screams to life with that raunchy, nasty exhaust note that the brand has become famous for. I knew the car was fast as soon as I pressed on the gas pedal, and then immediately went to full throttle. The instructor is constantly giving you verbal instructions on shifting points and pointing out what you should be looking for on the track. Going down the backstretch, the car has no problem exceeding 100 miles per hour, and that means the braking zone will be very critical as well. Despite my real life and my sim racing experience, the drive was still a bit overwhelming. The car was twitchy, it had massive braking power, and when pushing to the limits, the car moves around quite a bit. Full throttle, shift, shift, brakes, brakes, more brakes, turn in! Things were happening very quickly. So let's go ahead and just listen to a moment in one of my all-time favorite cars, the Ferrari F430 F1. Driving experience, the driving instructor will give you a debriefing that breaks down your drive. He will point out what you are doing well and where you can make improvements on your next drive. All in all, I did very well on my first run, but after some corrections made by the instructor, I was eager to calm down, self-reflect, and go at it again in a different car. And that was one of the other great things about exotics racing. It's on your pace. I have to be honest, one of my fears was that they're just gonna usher us through the three cars and I was gonna be gone just like that. But nope, it's really on you. After completing that ride, I was able to cool down, let the sweat dry off my brow, let the cramps in my hand subside. I was able to reflect on the whole drive, and when I was ready, I could go up to the board and let them know which would be my next pick to drive. So while I was cooling down, that's probably a good opportunity to hear from one of the instructors there at Exotic Racing what it's like being there in the car, shotgun, next to a maniac like someone like me. What's it like taking just novices? I mean, so I'm sure you get a wide variety of talent, actually. So what's it like, the drivers that you see come through here?
We really get a range of someone who's not comfortable driving a car to the limit, have no idea, they've never played, you know, Gran Turismo or Forza or anything growing up, so it's all new to them, to the people that they own a Ferrari and they literally just come here to drive ours on the track because they don't want to put wear and tear on it. So we have anyone and everyone on the spectrum as far as experience or non-experience goes. So it's honestly really fun to, for me when I'm doing the class, I also do the discovery laps. So it's cool to get a feel for people's experience levels and kind of adapt their my instructing to them so I can meet them where they are. Because a lot of people, they just want to drive a Ferrari because it's been on their bucket list and they just want to see what the acceleration is like on the straightaways. And there's other people that really start to understand the concepts and, you know, start to piece things together naturally. And it's really cool seeing them progress lap by lap by lap. And getting up to speed, and they understand the little nuances that I, you know, say, hey, do this a little bit differently. And they're like, oh, okay, I get it.
Right.
So it's really fun seeing the people that don't have a ton of experience start to pick things up really quickly, or people that maybe have hit a plateau and they start to break through and start to, you know, really progress at a fast rate. So it's fun.
Having seen it firsthand, I mean, these cars are built for the street. They're all street legal cars,
yeah.
Except your race car.
Yeah.
And yet, is this really the environment they're really built for? I mean, do you think the car's better suited to do this living here at Exotic Racing than being on the street with a license plate?
So I have a bit of a unique perspective because I also do the supercar tour that we host in Santa Monica. So every day I'm either playing with them on the racetrack or leading a tour on the streets. And over the past few months, getting really firsthand experience with both, they're very well suited for both. You know, I'm biased, I'm a race car driver, I'm sure just you're the same, you want to just be pushing these cars to the limits and experiencing the raw potential of these cars. And they do it exceptionally well, and it really shows you that these things shouldn't be driven hard on the streets. They're meant to be driven hard on a racetrack. But when you're just cruising around and looking cool and having the lifestyle experience associated with it, they really tick both boxes. It really comes down to personal preference at that point.
So the perfect scenario is what you named earlier. I should own my own Ferrari, but I should come here to beat up on one.
Yeah, I'd say so.
So now I'm sure, again, you get a wide variety of talent and even aggression levels coming through here. I'm a maniac. I shouldn't say this. We're about to get the cars. I'm a maniac. Fear doesn't exist.
Yeah.
Do you ever feel like you're taking, I mean, I don't want to put it morbid. Do you ever feel like you're taking your life in someone else's hands? And how do you deal with letting somebody who maybe shouldn't be driving that hard drive with you sitting as a passenger?
To be honest, I think we've all gotten pretty good at anticipating things well before they happen. As soon as we get in the car with someone, we can instantly read what they're going to be driving like. And as soon as we see a couple red flags, we're pretty good at preventing anything that might happen. And at the end of the day, we have a ton of runoff here. We have our own brake pedal. We're very good at, you know, taking over on the wheel if we need to. And we lay down the foundation, starting with the classroom, to get these guys to have a safe experience first. You know, yeah, we're hyping them up, and it's the most exciting day of their lives. But at the end of the day, every single one of our employees, our number one priority is safety. And we've gotten really, really good at making sure everyone stays under control while pushing these cars to the limits. So are there sticky situations every once in a while? It's the name of the game. Do I feel like my life is really ever 100% on the line? Not really. I feel like we've really created a safe environment to be able to test these cars out and play with these cars and give people experiences whilst keeping a behind the line of safety.
Then it was time for me to drive the Lamborghini. And just my luck, the Gallardo wasn't there that day, so they actually upgraded me to a Huracan at no expense to me. So now I was gonna drive a Lamborghini Huracan. An incredible convertible model in glowing green of a car with 580 horsepower and the ability to get to 60 miles per hour in 3.4 seconds and a top speed of 198 miles an hour. The car is much quieter than the Ferrari, and it is also very smooth by comparison as well. And despite going even faster than the Ferrari, it did it in a much more calm, much more controlled manner.
Spots, you gotta just wait for it to hook up.
And from listening to the instructor, you can tell that I did make some massive improvements over my first run.
All right. Dude, Sean, nicely done, bro.
Thank you.
That was awesome.
Thank you.
You did a great job.
Yeah, now you can tell the other guy I can drive.
Yeah.
He thought I was an idiot.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no.
You know, the thing is like, I knew right off the bat when I saw you, like, you're aggressive, but I saw you could catch the oversteer and you could do whatever. So I was like, I felt like I was fine and safe.
Right?
I didn't have, like, too much worried.
So now it was time for my third car. And can you say that I saved the best for last? It was time for the Porsche 911 GT3. Now, I have been a huge Porsche fan for most of my life. My uncle had one back in 76, I believe it was. The car's roots date back to the 60s, and the 911 is one of the most iconic road cars in the entire world. But this one, this lovely beast, is a 500 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 3.8 second, 198 mile per hour version, and the car that I wanted to drive the most. If the Ferrari was twitchy and raunchy, and if the Lamborghini was just too easy to tame, well then the Porsche was just right. When controlled by a heavy-footed gas pedal, it is a beast of a car and launches out of the corners at a ridiculous speed for a street car. It's braking, its balance, its hard charging power at the ready had the GT3 living up to every expectation I had of the car. It was even better than I had imagined.
Hey, break up, bring more. Yeah, perfect. Down in. Gentle. Yeah, back on the throttle. Very squeeze. Brake super hard.
Yes.
Slow down. Yeah, turn in. Turn more. Yeah, unwind and squeeze. Unwind. Yes. Alright, brake straight, brake more. Yeah, turn in, enter. No. You see if you back.
turn in?
Yeah.
It goes so fast. It goes so fast.
Super. Yeah, but I think the time lapse is really good.
And in my driver briefing, you could hear that I continue to get better, making massive improvements, and maybe even starting to get the hang of driving these supercars. But more importantly, most importantly, I had an ear-to-ear grin, perma-grin, that took days, weeks, months, still hasn't worn off my face when I think about it.
Really good. To be honest, I have almost nothing to say. You are super soft, perfect. Just be careful sometimes, you see if you back on the throttle a little bit too early.
Okay.
The weight of the car in the middle and you lose the grip of the front
right,
tire.
Right, right.
You can take a little bit of time. You see, you have the chicane. Sometimes, at the beginning it was good and after you want to go a little bit faster, but I think it's not really faster. At the chicane, you turn really good because you turn a little bit.
So in the end, this was one of the greatest experiences of my entire life. I mean, it was just fun through the roof. I still cannot believe that I have now driven a Ferrari, a Lamborghini, and a super Porsche at those kind of speeds. I was a little fearful that they're gonna keep you held back, make sure you had the skills before they uncorked you and let you go. But to Exotics Racing's credit, not only do they let you go as fast as you want, they encourage you to go as fast as you can go. If you have confidence, they have confidence, and it all works out. Again, it was one of the greatest experiences of my life, and I never imagined that I'd be able to drive these cars and drive them to this level. Now, at over $800, I spent some serious money. I can't think of many ways that you can blow that much money in that short amount of time, but at the same time, I drove over $500,000 worth of cars. I drove over 1,500 horsepower of exotic, iconic cars. I knocked three serious things off my bucket list, and I still can't believe what they let me do in those cars. It was insanity. I still can't believe they let a maniac like me drive like that in that kind of value of cars. If you want information on exotic racing, because it's something that you need to check out, go to exoticracing.com and see their list of supercars, programs, venues. And if you're the kind of guy that people complain about, the ones that are so hard to buy a gift for, well then have them, have your wife watch this show right now. I'm also gonna release all three individual track drives from start to finish so you can hear the pregame, the actual laps, and actual full debriefing of all three cars, the Ferrari, the Lamborghini, and the Porsche. I'll release those as soon as this show goes live as well. But that's gonna do it for this one. What a great time, what an experience. This is the Simpit. I'm Sean Cole, and I'll see you on the track in a Ferrari, Lamborghini, or maybe even a Porsche. Thank you.